He had overcome the darkness. He had reached the mountain. He could finally find his sister. As he reached the summit, Olle felt regret. He could not stop his sister from being taken. Regret could not stop the woman from drowning her child. The shapeshifter in the forest. Now the mountain stood before him, and he wished he could ask their forgiveness. He had reached the end that Tuva had pointed him towards. Now, entering the halls of the mountain, Ulle was ready to find his sister. Long ago, there was a peaceful kingdom that lacked an heir to the throne. She gave birth to the longed-for son, and they named him Ulrik. But suddenly, Exhausted, bloody, and at his wit's end, King Nils came to a witch's house on the outskirts of his kingdom. He fell to his knees, begging the witch to help cure his son, and she agreed. The witch explained that the flower held tremendous power that could only very carefully be used for good. The witch instructed he only use a single petal. Using the whole bloom would only invite death. Ulrik began to recover, but discontent at the royal line had grown in the kingdom following King Nils' bloody campaign. The next day, King Nils found his son dead, and the last light holding his darkness at bay was snuffed out. Heartbroken, King Nils turned to the bloom which had promised life, and instead saw it as an escape from his suffering. The witch, having come to visit the king and the prince, looked at the nightmarish scene in despair. She raised a mountain on top of King Nils and shackled him using the same bramble that he let loose upon the kingdom. And to this day, the trolls still feed him as punishment for his evil deed.
Thank you. Thank you.
closed forever, now opened. The Mountain King, who was meant to be hidden forever, was now revealed. He just had to reach the sack before Lillimor ended up as the giant's dinner.